Hi everybody, and welcome to My Doggy Crafting. Today we are going to be painting with acrylic paint, and we are going to be painting birdhouses. Okay, so, originally I was supposed to take a painting class on birdhouses, surprisingly, to paint these. I guess they're going to show me some techniques, stuff like that, but, it ended up being canceled, so, I'm just going to show you guys how to do it here. Alright, so the first house we're going to be painting is this little birdhouse right here. I'm picking this one out of the three I have because it's probably going to be the shortest so that you can skip to the end of the video to do the others. I have not decided yet if I'm going to do these in separate videos, but I don't want to lose your guys' attention. So let's get started. Today I'm going to just simply start off by putting the paint directly on the house because I'm not really going to be adding any detail, anything like that. So first I'm going to start off using my medium brush to paint the roof, and the color I'm going to be using is this blue. I already checked, and these paints, apparently, they don't have the covering on the inside, so it's just direct. So, I'm just going to put a little at the top, and the thing you want to know about putting it on the top is that you have to be quick. Okay, so now I'm going to be using the green.
Plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel this so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens, but no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine just on the night, like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show.
Anyways, I'm going to be putting pink and yellow on this one. Well, not really.
Greetings, loved ones. Let's take a journey.
I know a place where the grass is really greener. Warm, wet, and wild. There must be something in the water. Sipping gin and juice. Laying underneath the palm trees.
Okay.
And
yellow on the front, and I'm just going to paint with the same paintbrush I kind of wiped off, and I like the effect. When I wiped it off, it turned out into this sunset greeny yellowy thing, and I didn't even use any yellow there, but I guess sunset, I don't know. Anyways, yeah. Oh yeah, and if you're wondering, when I opened this yellow, which was for the first time, it did not break on me. Don't you love when things like you not want to break on you? Doesn't everybody? Anyways, okay, so I'm kind of giving it this rustic look and kind of painting kind of roughly. Just painting roughly. Like that. So it's a light yellow if you can see it. So now I'm just going to use the same brush, which actually didn't have much paint on it. And I'm going to go ahead, shake up my purple. Please don't break. doesn't break. So you got my purple, and I'm gonna place them at the top. Oh, that's locked. And tiny bottom, because I've used a lot on top. I only have a little amount here. But, okay, so I'm going to just paint and paint and paint it. And please don't get on there. Okay, it didn't. And I'm just kind of letting it go wherever it wants. For some reason, this yellow reminds me a lot of Winnie the Pooh. Like, a lot. I know it's this color, but oh, it just reminds me a lot of Winnie the Pooh. And so that just kind of looks really cool because it's got the background of a yellow and the foreground of a purple. And right now I'm just going on the inside with the purple of the heart so that, you know, have some definition there. It's not just plain wood, you know. So I have the front done. I mean, I can leave some yellow here because this stupid little knob thing doesn't want to let me paint around it. And I think that looks really cool, the front. Yes, really cool. You see? But if you're wondering about the sides, because they look like crap right now, we'll fix them. Don't worry. Alright, so now I'm going to take yellow and green and just put them on the back. Because, I mean, come on, we can probably use. Okay, well, for this side, the left side, I had I painted a base, not a base, but just like on the side was a pink, and then I added the blue on top of the pink and everything, and kind of just blended away. And you can see it'll show the wood behind, and I really like that finish. And I also had to get under the roof because that I wanted to make sure that got painted. So now we're going to do pink and purple. I mean, not pink and purple, blue and purple. So now we're going to do blue and purple. I'm going to do, well, I usually do the lighter color first so that the darker color can kind of go over it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Feel a phoenix inside of me as I march alone to a different beat. Slowly swallowing down my fear. Yeah, yeah. I am ready for the road that's.
We're doing the side four. I'm just gonna put some water on it, stuff like that. And what I'm going to do is take the color that was there, so thank goodness I had just had a plain purple there. And I'm just going to put it on here. Wet my brush a little. And then go ahead and paint. Alright, for the edges, I'm going to go ahead and use a white paint, because with the white, it blends into everything, and sometimes it makes it a little bit, look a little bit better. So for this one, I'm going to take a smaller brush than I had before. You can use bigger depending on how you want to, like, you know, contrast.
She is a pyramid, but with him she's just a grain of sand. This love's too strong like my cement, squeezing out the life that should be lit in. She was a hurricane king. But now she's just a gust of wind. She used to set the sails of a thousand ships. Was a force to be reckoned with. She could be a Statue of Liberty. She could be a Joan of Arc.
Alright, okay. So, for the other side, I'm going to do a different color, and I hope I just did not get all of my paint and hard work on my hand. So, I'm just going to trim this sideways so you can kind of see the front of the house. I'm going to do a color that will stand out. Yellow won't really stand out. Let's do pink on the front. I don't use much pink. So, I'm also going to get rid of some of the paint on here by just by just placing it on its side. That'll like lessen, you know, your chance of doing it by just, you know, getting rid of it now. Like, be gone. So anyways, I'm gonna do it directly on here because it's dark color. And I'm mostly gonna put the paint on the dark spots. Okay, so for this one, I'm going to take the blue, and I'm just going to go on the inner roof and just paint away because I'm not really caring right now, but I'm going to place it on my paintbrush because it's going to, it's just going to go everywhere. The bottom is going to be kind of hard, so that's why I already had it on here, and I'm going to go ahead and just use the same paintbrush, whoa, that was a lot, and just go ahead and paint.
He put it on me, I put it on. Like there was nothing wrong, it didn't fit, it wasn't right. Wasn't just the size, they say you know when you know. I don't know. I didn't feel the fairy tale feeling. No, am I a stupid girl for even dreaming that I could, if it's not like the movies, that's how it should be.
And we finished the birdhouse. Let's just go over what we've done. We have both roofs with the rustic feel. And then we have the sides and under the roofs, the front, the side, the back, the side, the side, the back. And then the bottom, sadly, still has this on it. But overall, we have all this.